अगेन आर ऑल्सो द नॉन फाइनाइट वर्ब्स एंड जेरंड्स आर ऑल्सो द नॉन फाइनाइट वर्ब्स. जेरंड्स अगेन फंक्शंस एज अ नाउन इन द सेंटेंस, बट दे ऑल्सो हैव आईएनजी फॉर्म एंड प्रेजेंट पार्टिसिपल इज अ नॉन फाइनाइट वर्ब दैट फंक्शंस एज एन एडजेक्टिव और अ वर्ब एंड हैज आईएनजी फॉर्म. सो हाउ विल यू रिकॉग्नाइज वेदर इट इज अ जेरंड और अ प्रेजेंट पार्टिसिपल? So the basic difference is gerund will be working as a noun, whereas present participle will be working as an adjective or a verb in the sentence. This has to be kept in mind. Let's see an example. Swimming is a good exercise. So swim is a verb which has been converted as a noun in the sentence by adding ing. So swimming is working as a noun in the sentence. Swimming is a good exercise. Example, we can take coughing exhausts Ellen. So coughing is working as a noun in the sentence. And if we talk about a present participle in the sentence, they can be used as an adjective or a verb. So here we have got two examples to make it more clear to understand. We were swimming in the river. Were swimming. Were is again a helping verb, which is helping the main verb swimming. And therefore, swimming has become a participle because it is used as a verb in the sentence. Getting it? And therefore, it is a participle. If we see second example, Anjum likes his new swimming shorts, right? So here, swimming shorts, shorts noun, swimming is modifying the noun shorts. So here swimming is used as an adjective. So this is how we have used swimming in three forms: as a noun, as a participle, and as an adjective. I hope you all have understood what are gerunds and how they work. Please do watch the videos of finite and non-finite, and hope you will queries will be solved after watching the video. I will be ending up the session over here. Thank you very much for listening me. Goodbye children, take care.